This video accompanies Open Interest Statistics, Section 1.1, Case Study, Using Stents to Prevent Strokes. In this video, we will learn about treatment and control groups, we will be introduced to data tables and summary statistics, and we will have a chance to see an interesting data set with a surprising story. In this section, we will consider an experiment that studies the effectiveness of stents in treating patients at risk of stroke. Stents are devices put inside blood vessels that assist in patient recovery after cardiac events and reduce the risk of an additional heart attack or death. Many doctors have hoped that there would be similar benefits for patients at risk of stroke. We'd like to know, does the use of stents reduce the risk of stroke? The researchers who asked this question collected data on 451 at-risk patients. Each volunteer patient was randomly assigned to one of two groups. Patients in the treatment group received a stent and medical management. The medical management included medications, management of risk factors, and help and lifestyle modification. Patients in the control group received the same medical management as the treatment group, but they did not receive stents. In this study, the control group provides a reference point against which we can measure the medical impact of stents in the treatment group. Researchers studied the effect of stents at two time points, 30 days after enrollment and 365 days after enrollment. The results of two patients are displayed in the table below. Patient outcomes are recorded as stroke or no event, representing whether or not the patient had a stroke at the end of a time period. Considering data from each patient individually would be a long, cumbersome path towards answering the original research question. Instead, performing a statistical data analysis allows us to consider all of the data at once. The table below summarizes the raw data in a more helpful way. For instance, to identify the number of patients in the treatment group who had a stroke within 30 days, we look on the left side of the table at the intersection of treatment and stroke. 33. We can compute summary statistics from the table. A summary statistic is a single number based on the sample that summarizes a large amount of data. For instance, the primary results of the study after 1 year could be described by two summary statistics: the proportions of people who had a stroke in the treatment and control groups. The proportion who had a stroke in the treatment or stent group was 45/224, or 20%. The proportion who had a stroke in the control group was 28/227, or 12%. These two summary statistics are useful in looking for differences in the groups, and we are in for a surprise. Comparing 20% to 12%, we see that an additional 8% of the patients in the treatment group had a stroke. This is important for two reasons. First, it is contrary to what doctors expected, which was that stents would reduce the rate of strokes. Second, it leads to a statistical question. Do the data show a real difference between the groups? Well, suppose you flip a coin 100 times. While the chance a coin lands heads in any given coin flip is 50%, we probably won't observe exactly 50 heads. This type of fluctuation is part of almost any type of data generating process. It is possible that the 8% difference in the stent study is due to this natural variation. However, the larger the difference we observe for a particular sample size, the less believable it is that the difference is due to chance. In this video, we learned about treatment and control groups. We were introduced to data tables and summary statistics, and we saw an interesting data set with a surprising story. If you learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend and visit openintro.org for more resources.